As some of you may know, my fiancé and I actually did co-op gaming videos on this channel for a couple years. We've since moved that to a separate channel, which we're relaunching here in 2016, so link to that in the description below, but we've done a lot of co-op videos over the past 3 to 4 years. For that, I needed a fast way to transfer the files between our two gaming PCs. We primarily use DxStory to record our co-op videos, and those end up making some huge video files. That's no problem when you're recording and editing on the same PC, but becomes a problem when you need to move the footage from one PC to another in a timely fashion. Network transfer wasn't fast enough, USB 3.0 hard drives weren't fast enough, we needed a much stronger solution. It ended up being easier than I imagined. The solution I always assumed would be best to quickly transfer hundreds of gigabytes at a time between our two gaming PCs was a 10 gigabit networking connection. But Ethernet switches with 10 gigabit ports cost hundreds of dollars that I didn't have available to spend at the time, or now. Conveniently, I ran across a thread on the Linus Tech Tips forum from a user FakeNG who was trying to accomplish a similar goal. A week later, maybe a little more accounting for eBay product shipping and such, I got it set up. Let's see what it takes. My goal was to establish direct file sharing between two PCs that performed faster than my normal gigabit network could handle and faster than using external hard drives and swapping them between computers. To do this, I set up a direct 10 gigabit connection between the two PCs while still allowing them to connect to the internet and the rest of my home network via their normal gigabit network connection. So I took to eBay and purchased two Mellanox Connect XR one port SFP Plus 10 gigabit Ethernet cards. These were used from old servers and cost me $45 total. Not bad, was much better than I thought this would cost. I also grabbed a brand new Cisco Twinax SFP Plus cable, 5 meters in length, for 30 bucks. I ended up having to wait extra long for it as the seller somehow got the first one returned to them by the post office damaged, but it still worked out. And surprisingly, that's all it really took. I didn't need special drivers for Windows or anything. Pop the SFP cards in the PCIe slots of the two PCs, run the SFP Plus Twinax cable between them, and well, nothing changed. Copying files between the PCs was still slow as balls. What gives? Well, Windows isn't too smart when it comes to having multiple network connections. It sees that internet access is available via the normal gigabit Ethernet connection and just uses that for all communication. So to make the computers talk to each other via the 10 gigabit connection, you have to do a couple different things. So to do so, go to your network adapter settings, which you can access from your network and sharing center. On your PCs, find your Mellanox Connect X2 Ethernet adapter, right click it, go to properties. Select the IPv4 listing and click properties again. Click the button for use the following IP address and assign one PC, give it the IP 1.1.1.1, and give the other PC the IP address of 1.1.1.2. For the subnet mask, put in 255.255.255.252 for both, and leave the default gateway empty and leave the DNS servers empty as well, since you won't be connecting to the internet through this connection, they are not needed. Keep in mind though, if you do want to share an internet connection between the two PCs via this connection, that is possible, but that will add in extra latency as PC1 has to connect through PC2 and whichever PC is the gateway has to stay on pretty much at all times for the second PC to connect. Now, restart both PCs. If you haven't already, set up a shared folder on each PC. These folders should be the ones you use to communicate between them. For convenience and ease of setup, I've set up a file dump folder on the fastest drive, usually a solid state drive on each PC. Right click your folder, go to properties and click advanced sharing. Check share this folder and give it a share name, something that is easy to remember and does not have spaces in it. Click permissions and make sure there is a user listing for everyone. If there isn't, click add and simply type in everyone and click okay. Now select everyone in the user list and check the box below allow for full control. Click apply and okay, and maybe apply and okay again. Do the same thing for the folder on your other PC. If you want to transfer files between the PCs via these folders now, it will still use the slower network connection. So to fix this, you want to manually map a network drive or network mapped folder or shortcut by using the 1.1.1 and 1.1.1.2 IP addresses that we set up before. Go to this PC, aka my computer, and check map network drive. If you're on Windows 10 and don't see it, just right click empty space and click add network location. Click next. Choose a custom network location, next, and then in this text box, type 2 backslashes that IP address, so either 1.1.1.1 or 1.1.1.2, backslash and then the name of the share you created. This is why you can't have spaces, because while spaces work locally, when you're trying to connect over the network with a space, it doesn't know what to do. So use underscores instead of spaces. Click next, give it a name for a shortcut on your computer, click next, and then click finish. This will open up that share. Congrats! Now if you transfer files between these PCs via the use of these shares, they will transfer via the faster 10 gigabit connection. In most cases, your SATA bus speeds and hard drive speeds won't be anywhere near fast enough to saturate and run a full 10 gigabit speed, but it will certainly be much faster than transferring over your normal network, especially if you're using solid state drives. Now on our gaming PCs, which were built, you know, faster and such, I was getting around 150 megabits per second, or megabytes per second, that's the important differentiation, megabytes per second between our two recording RAIDs. I have two RAID 0 hard drive arrays set up on each computer, and transferring between them, I was getting about 150 megabytes per second, which was much faster than through the normal gigabit network. However, I've now switched that card out of Choose Gaming PC into my transcoding server, so I can just dump all footage to that. It has slower SATA speeds and slower drives in it. It actually is running laptop hard drives at the moment, and so I'm getting slower speeds, but still faster than I would get through my normal network connection. But that's it. The shares will remain accessible as long as the respective PC is on. Keep in mind that if a PC is off and you accidentally click the shortcut on your other PC, Windows Explorer will hang for a bit. Nothing is wrong, it will just keep trying to connect. If Wake on LAN is enabled on your PC's BIOS, you might even turn on the PC by accident by clicking that shortcut. But that's it. Thanks for watching my video on the 10 gigabit connections between two gaming PCs. I do hope you enjoyed. If you'd like to see more custom tech projects like these, get subscribed, smash that like button, and leave me a comment down below. Otherwise, my name is Adam Ripples Vox, and I will catch you in the next one.